Today we're going to talk about how to do cooling fans on the Bigtree Tech Manta M4P version 2.1. Now, as you can see on the actual board today, we have three actual fans. So we have our fan 0, our fan 1, and our fan 2, and our fan 2B. This might be a little bit off, but these share an actual signal pin, which I'll show you in a moment. So essentially what we want to do is create a cooling situation for when this actually is active. So what I'm going to do right now is just plug this in with the notch connector on the fan 2 connection, and I'm going to actually energize the system. So what we'll do now is we'll actually confirm this in the documentation. So I'll go over to the desktop of the computer, and as you can see here, we actually have the actual pinouts for this. So if we look over here, we have fan 1, we have fan 2, and you can see there are two of them here. So you have a 2A and a 2B, and they share a pin. Now there's also a fan 0 that should show up here, but apparently it's right here, and then it goes fan 1. So as you can see, fan 0, 1, 2A, and 2B. And these have the same signal pin, these have different ones. So there are three fans in total that you can use. So in order to set this fan up, we actually have to check the documentation. So if I click over here, and I go to, let's see, install configuration. Actually, I might be in the wrong place, but let's see. Install configuration. It's actually configuration reference right here. So if we scroll down a little bit, what we can see is there's a section for fans. And as you can see, if we click on it, it brings you directly to it. Now there's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 types of fans. They're all very similar, but have slightly different configurations. The one that we want to use is the controller fan. So as you can see right here, you have a pin, then you have max power, shutdown speed, and a bunch of other things that are commented out. Now in my case, I'm only going to be using a couple of these. And some of these I have yet to make work, like the idle timeout. But hopefully in the future I'll be able to understand that better, but at the moment I can't get it working. So I'm going to show you how the actual fan will work. So if we go over to here and I reconnect, what we want to do is we want to go to our configuration, then the printer configuration. And what we need to do is actually add in a fan controller, which I've already done here. So you can see there's a controller fan. Then you have your pin. I'm saying it's activated on the X stepper. Now this can be multiple steppers. You could say that it's also stepper Y or stepper Z, or you could do stepper, I think it's the extruder, but in order to find that, the easiest way to do it is actually look through here, because you can see they're already tagged. So in this case, it would be extruder. So if we copy that and then go up here, we could paste it right here, or we can type extruder and it would auto-populate for us. Like so. So this is the actual fan speed I'm going to be running at. The idle timeout I decided not to use. And then idle speed, you have to have this if you're doing the, I'm putting a comment here for you, the G code M84, which is stop motors. So let's go back and actually save out of here for a second. And we'll go back over and see if we can watch this at the same time that we work with it. So let me click on here. And what we're going to do is we're actually going to move the axis. So in this case, I'm going to home, and you'll see that the fan right here will become active for the x-axis. So you see how it's turned up, and it's going pretty much half its normal speed. Now, if we want to move the axis over, let's say 100, we can do that. But we can't shut the fan off without doing a motors off. So what you're going to need to do is watch what the G code is over here. And you can see that it's M84. So that's what's causing the actual fan to stop. If you want to prove that that actual configuration doesn't work, you can always go over here and hit the control forward slash to comment this out. Save and reset. Then you'll go back over to here, and we'll home the axis again. The fan goes on. We'll actually move it 100 millimeters, and we'll click motors off and watch the fan. So as you can see, the fan does not turn off when you do the M84. So we know that this is actually related to it. So this was a rather short tutorial on this, and I have this information already at hand for you to see. But let's confirm it real quick here and save and restart it again. And at this point, I actually want to thank my people on PayPal as well as Patreon. I'll put a thank you note in the end, and you can see your name if you're there. And everyone, take care, be safe, and have a nice day.